You know, Lake Oahe is just a massive reservoir, over 200 miles long, starts in Pierce, South Dakota, basically winds all the way up south of Bismarck, North Dakota. And when you look at all this water, and you look at the smallmouth bass population, I mean, if Lake Oahe was in Texas or Arkansas or Alabama, it'd probably be one of the most notorious, well-known bass fisheries in the country, you know, with the population of fish.
Look at this.
That is a football. Look at them all.
Oh, wow.
Here we
There's
go.
There's a charger.
That's what we're looking for.
Yeah, that's some
that's what we're
cool stuff. Not very far away either.
It's like when you find those big schools too, it's just like they're competing against each other. That's when they bite. Try to chase one around and they don't want to cooperate. There, we got them.
Oh, that's a good one.
That is a good fish. Look at that.
Tell me when you're ready, Jace. If you need the net, I'll net him for you.
Boy, they just don't stop digging. Yeah, go ahead and scoop her up. Boy, that's gorgeous. They're just so long.
Yeah, they're
long and strong.
Sturdy fish. Yes, they are.
All right. Thank you, sir.
I just choked it.
That fish was quite a ways off the bottom. Just a great representation of a smallmouth bass right there. When you look around here, it doesn't look like smallmouth country, does it? We're one of the, I guess what you call one of the top walleye fisheries in the country as far as a walleye fishery. It's got a lot of history, big tournaments out here every year. Lake Oahe here in South Dakota, massive reservoir on the Missouri River system, and probably one of the best kept secrets on this whole lake. This lake has a phenomenal, phenomenal smallmouth bass fishery. And smallmouths are one of my favorite fish to target and catch. Got fish all over. Just amazing to me how much they move. You know, I just never realized that. Oh, right here. Right back there, Kerry.
Oh yeah, we're running now. Man. That's what we're looking for. My golly, huh?
Showing them all kinds of them right to the left of the boat here right now. It's like we're casting into schools of them. That is cool.
This is a good one.
I'll get the net here for you.
You're still digging.
Yeah. That's what we like about them.
Might get a jump here. Oh, boy.
Yep. That is a big smallmouth. I don't care where you're at.
I'm pretty tight on it, but he's just... All right, might be getting ready to come out from under there. Oh my. Get out of there, buddy.
That is a big
one. He comes. Coming to you. There we go.
Hey, jumped right into the net. Nice job.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a great fish. It's kind of a deal. We all have to walleye fish to make a living, but for fun, it's fun to come out here and fish for these, huh?
We'll get this one back in the water and get another one. That's a dandy South Dakota bronze right there. Let her go here. There she is.
It was fun chasing him around with this live sight.
Yep, I could see where that would be.
You know, before I started using this type of technology, I think what has taught me the most is just how much fish move and how fast they move.
Sure.
I mean, they're screaming. We got a bunch of them that moved in right to the left of the boat here.
Okay.
There, we got them. Wow, they're stacking. The live sight just, whoa, just lit up. Isn't that a cool way to catch a fish? Look at that. Look at them all following it. There's a couple more with it. That is so cool. Look at that. Oh, gotta be South Dakota's best kept secret.
Just studs.
Just strong.
Look at that. They just dig.
You cannot move these. Tell them what to do. Look at that. Look at that.
There we come. Oh, there, he's ready.
All right, thank you, sir. That is a gorgeous, gorgeous fish. Yeah. Isn't that cool? One of my favorite fish to catch and target. That's good stuff. All right. Swam off angry. You know, these smallmouths can be pretty simple to find in the sense that you take any of your big primary points. If you look at a topographic map of Lake Oahe, any of your big deep reefs and big deep points that cut out into the deep water, they have some sand and rock on those spots. It seems like they're holding bass. And you know, they're also going to hold walleyes. You're going to find walleyes in these locations as well. But what's interesting, it seems like the smallmouth bass, you'll get bunches of fish, where if you go off the end of a point, you're seeing, you know, four or five marks, and they're a little bit deeper. You know, you can, they almost have like a box shape when they come across the screen. You know, those are your schools of smallmouths. Where walleyes, you know, they'll come across one at a time, there'll be a longer mark. And a lot of times they'll be closer to the bottom. But when you see four, five, six, 10 marks, and they're stacked on top of each other, a lot of times those are your smallmouths. And so you go off the tips of these points, they're going to show up on your electronics. You can find them with your electronics and just drop down and fish. And probably the easiest way, put the spot lock down and just cast around the boat, jig below the boat, and you're going to catch all kinds of smallmouths.
There's one.
Good one.
Oh, look at that.
Oh my. Look at that.
That's what we're looking for.
Horsepower these fish have. Try to keep it in the water. Sometimes you don't have a choice.
Come here.
Oh, another chunk.
Yeah, that is a nice one.
That is what we're here for. Look at that, right in the hard part of the beak. Gorgeous. Yeah, good stuff. Good stuff. That is fun. I'll show you the bait that we're using. This is Northland Fishing Tackle Ripping Minnow. You see here, it's got the plastic fin on it. And you can put any type of fluke style bait on this. And you know, Cody Roswick kind of came up with this. This is his brainchild. And what's interesting is he was actually meeting with some of these guides down here, like Brett Kemenitz over in Mobridge. And what these guides wanted was a jigging wrap style bait that they could put a soft plastic on. And so that's how this came about. But the cool thing about this, you can get different, obviously different sizes, different colored heads, and then you can swap this out. I mean, you can put a Zoom fluke on there. They come pre-packaged with a fluke tail on it, but same type of cadence, drop it down or pitch it, and it's just snapping. Pop, and you'll see this lure will just creen up off the bottom and then spiral down, creen up off the bottom and spiral down. And what's really cool is when you watch these fish on the live site, I mean, you'll give that lure a pop and it'll just creen up and it'll flash, move water, it pulls in fish from a long ways and it just triggers fish. You'll just see them just come in and investigate it. So really a cool way to catch a fish. When they hit these, they slam them. So great smallmouth lure, great walleye lure, whenever you have fish relating to structure.
There's a lot of smallmouth bass. The quality is incredible. Just, you know, we're so fortunate. We have plenty of forage for them, it seems like. They've really flourished over the years. You can go out and the average size is going to probably run you that 16 to 18 inches, just really quality smallmouths and some bigger ones. This past summer, we actually just had the new state record broke just south of here. So yeah, the smallmouth fishery is really coming on, and it's something new, you know. If people like to fish and they get their walleyes, come out, go try to catch some smallmouths and have some fun. Pound for pound, they're probably the fightingest fish there is when you hook one on a line. You can catch them, you know, artificials, plastics, crankbaits, but a jig in a plastic is a lot of fun, you know, if you want to get really hands-on fishing. Come on out to Mobridge and try the smallmouth fishing and watch the Bassmasters do their thing.
So when these fish get on this type of structure where they're relating to the ends of points in deeper water especially, that's really where this live site shines. And basically what it is it's a sonar that you, where you can look ahead. And so here, this is the arrow, and this is just a Bruce City arm where you can mount the bracket onto it, and you can just pan it and then look for fish. And then obviously on your sonar itself, you can see how many feet away the fish are. And so they might be 20 feet to the side, 10 feet to the side, they might be right below the boat. And so it's really a neat option for like looking for crappies, looking for walleyes, looking for smallmouths like we are here today, where you can just scan the structure and then you can know where to pull the boat to or know where to cast. And it isn't for everything. I mean, there's certain situations where fish don't show up well. If you have like an uneven bottom where fish can lay in the bottom, it seems like if the fish get up off the bottom, that's where it shines, but it really can be a useful tool for certain things. Probably the biggest takeaway that I've seen from fishing with it is that there are days, there are times where the fish are moving really fast. So I'm talking, I've got my screen set at 30 feet across. There's times where a fish will swim across that screen in 3 seconds. It's amazing how fast and how much these fish move at times. And when you see these fish, it can be easy to get caught in the trap where you're chasing after it, trying to catch up with that one fish. When fish are moving that much, just plant yourself and let the fish move to you. Don't try to chase them. But when they're just slowly moving around, they're just camped on specific spots, that's where this shines. And so either way, it gives you a tremendous amount of knowledge. If the fish are moving fast, it can dictate how you fish, but also too, if the fish aren't moving a lot, you can just search them out and find them. And so very useful tool for a lot of different fishing applications. You know, no doubt the big appeal for people when they come out fishing out in this area is if you want to be, you can be alone all day long. I mean, there is so much water. You leave that boat ramp and you go north or south and there are miles of water. I mean, there are so many spots where, you know, you can spend the whole week fishing without another boat within a mile of you. You know, it's just that remote type setting. And when you're all by yourself out here in this beautiful lake and you look up, you've got these beautiful bluffs, you know, and just the, you know, just that wide open prairie. I mean, it's a special place and it just has a kind of a alluring quality that just, you know, there's a lot of people that come out here one time and they come out here every year because it's just that magical type of location where you can come out here, get away from people, not have anybody around you. And you, a lot of times when you pull up on these spots, you know, you feel like you're the only person to ever fish some of these locations. Obviously there's been people there before you, but you know, it's just that kind of that exploration element where you can just go out and explore and just find your own fish. Just really a lot of fun to come out here and fish.
But these are travelers, there's no doubt about it. They roam. They are nomads of the lake. No matter where I fished on the whole system, the surface temp's been the same. You would think the way up in the Grand would be warmer and then cooling quicker. It's been the same everywhere all year.
Got him.
Oh, that one is a digging. Look at them all on the live site. Yeah, that's a nice fish. Just love how they hit these. A fun way to catch a fish. And we can see them and chase them around with the electronics. That's as good as it gets.
See a hoister or you need the net?
You know, I'm just gonna land him.
Grab him, okay.
Come here. These are just gorgeous. There. You know what I think is really cool is that, you know, you look at South Dakota, kind of in the heart of walleye country, and these smallmouths are getting more attention all the time. And I thought it was really cool when the Bassmasters came up here a few years ago, the fact that they came back, but just a cool opportunity. Beautiful country, big water. The amount of spots that you could fish for smallmouths out here is endless. Just so many spots you can fish. Basically all these big primary points, and these big reefs, main lake structure that sticks way out. Up and down this reservoir, you're gonna find good smallmouths. So we're out of Mobridge here right now, which neat thing about Mobridge is you got all these different big creek arms and stuff. So there's a lot of different types of spots you can hit without a very far boat ride. You know, so you're looking at structure, you know, that's got that close proximity to the river channel. You know, the thing about that river channel is it's deep water and it's cold water, and there's a lot of pelagic bait fish in this system, you know, whether it's smelt, lake herring, whitefish, And it's almost like that old river channel is a highway for fish, where those bait fish move up and down the lake using that old river channel. And it's almost like these fish just sit up on the edge of that river channel and any type of piece of structure they can find and just ambush that bait as it comes by. And so it's just a very prominent tactical locational pattern for smallmouths, walleyes, and a lot of other fish. But it seems like a lot of times when you are catching smallmouths, there's usually walleyes nearby and vice versa. If you're catching walleyes, chances are there's smallmouths somewhere in the area. They might not be on the same rock pile doing the same thing, but usually where you find one species of fish, you're going to find other fish around as well. So I'm just here at my tackle bench here, just going over some smallmouth tackling. You know, when you look at Lake Oahe, you know, middle of summer, a lot of times these fish are on deeper structure. They're off the tips of the points, anywhere from say 8 all the way out to 20, 24 feet of water. And so it's a lot of jigs and a lot of drop shot. You can't go wrong. This is something anybody can do. It's real simple. A lot of different things are going to work to catch these smallmouths. And so you look at a lot of the jigs, you know, we're using ripping minnows, which, you know, later on in the summer, this water's really warm. And so we're just trying to get an aggressive response. You also too, you know, as water gets warm, I think a lot of times these fish pull out and they start eating a lot of these young of the year bait fish. But you can't go wrong with just crayfish imitating jigs, in the sense that even on Lake Oahe, there's a lot of crayfish these fish are eating. And so this is just a swimming craw, just a Shields Outfitter plastic, just rigged weedless on a jig. And sometimes you're gonna find some flooded willows, flooded cottonwoods, things like that off the tips of these points. This is just a mushroom head with just a finesse stick. Again, just another Shields Outfitter plastic. But you look at these plastics here, very versatile, very easy to use. And a lot of times I like to switch back and forth between white and pearls, silvers, and just that motor oil, pumpkin, brown, green colors. So I either go white or I go dark. Now a couple of other really great jig options that just come pre-packaged. In fact, you know, you see here, this Limberleech, Northland Fishing Tackle Limberleech comes in the package. This just catches everything. So again, you know, you fish below the boat, you make short casts around the boat, and you're basically just hopping along the bottom. If you do any walleye fishing at all, you already know how to use these. Mimic Minnow Critter Craw, same deal. Pre-packaged, imitates a crayfish. Just crawl along the bottom. You can't really do anything wrong as long as you're fishing in the right spots. You know, and besides using jigs, we also use a lot of drop shot. Drop shots work excellent for smallmouths. And so just a weight on the bottom, about a foot and a half, 2 feet off the bottom. We're just tying just a live bait hook on a palomar knot. And we're just nose hooking a plastic, either plastic worm, plastic fluke, some type of a minnow profile. But again, fish it just like a jig. But between the drop shots and the jigs, it's really hard to go wrong. Get on the tips of these points and fish structure. If you're a walleye angler in the Dakotas, chances are you already know how to fish this stuff. Just modify your tackle, get off the tips of these points, and you can just have a ball catching these fish.
There's one.
Fighter.
Oh, fighter. Oh, they're all fighters. You know, out here on Lake Oahe, like Jason was mentioning, we have fabulous smallmouth fishing. It's kind of an untapped fishery, and it's second to none in my opinion. But you know, you look for these points along channels, sharp drops, things like that there, and you can catch these babies all day long. You know, a little bit of rock. Probably see the wood up here. We have some trees. You know, shallow water next to deep water is where it's at. You know, when these fish come up, they're coming up for one reason, and that's the feed. So if you're there when they're there, it can be a great, great time for everyone. Let this girl go. She's off. The Missouri River system is just a piece of art is what it is, and living history, I guess, is what you would call it. Lewis and Clark come through in 1804 and went back in 1806. The people kind of tend to cater towards the outdoorsmen because that's a lot what we have here. Mobridge has really stepped it up in the 30 years I've been here, and I am very glad to call it home.
Oh, there's a big fish there. Oh, goodness, look at that. Look at that. Now they are so strong. Oh, stay on. Come here. Oh, look at that fish. Oh my, look at this. That's just a chunk. Look at that. That is a football. Wow, look at the girth, the belly, the build on these fish. Unbelievable. Get that butter bowl back in the water. There she goes. See you later. That is cool. What a cool fish.